the civil rights movement, as Professor Shelton said, was really getting steam in the mid-1960s. And there was a flagpole right outside this student center. It's gone now. I think it was on the west side of the student center, if I remember. Everything has changed so dramatically here. And one of those flagpoles had the Confederate flag. And some of the black students did not like it. Wonder why. They didn't like it. And they didn't like the whole theme of the Southern, of the South in this building. But the civil rights movement for black equality in this country is the granddaddy of it all. That's the fountain of the whole deal. It really was. That's the fountain of the whole deal. And it's important to know that. So, a gentleman in my apartment comes up to me, and I remember he used to smoke. He's deceased now, and he smoked. And he comes up to me, went to a very important university, and not mentioned any of these names, and he comes up and smoking, and he was about my height, and he started touching my hair, pulling my hair. Imagine this. What are you doing? You know, he says, I want to know your origin, crescendo here on the campus. Things were getting a little bit hot, more than hot. It was getting pretty tough. And I'm walking out on the campus, and I'm very impulsive. I'm impulsive and compulsive at the same time. I'm not sure how those two things merge, but it seems like it. Or they sort of rhyme together. And they always wanted to take down the Confederate flag. And the administration wouldn't do it. And there's a Confederate flag out there. There's a woman I'm walking outside with, a white woman. And I'm walking outside with her, and she said, hey, Saxe, why don't you take it down? We're discussing it. And all of a sudden, it's not that I wanted to prove anything. It's just that I operated that way, just the way I was. And all of a sudden, I started pulling down the flag, not knowing what I was doing. And all of a sudden, I'm surrounded by, I don't know, a good number of white students, white teachers, white administrators, and I thought they were literally going to kill me. I'm very serious. It was that kind of tension. The police came, but I was protected by a few black students, some black men, who literally surrounded me, and I was protected and sort of walked me off the campus. From that point on, everything shot up even more dramatically. By the way, I've got to get in some digs. The segregation in the South, in Texas, and all throughout the South, was the handmaiden of the Democratic Party. The Democratic Party under Lyndon Johnson changed its ways dramatically. But it must be said that the Democratic Party, that's part of their history, maintained, instigated, and fomented segregation. I didn't know really what was going on. I really didn't. I was doing these things, but I didn't think I was a part of history or anything. You just did them. You know what I mean? It was the right thing to do. At least I thought at that time it was the right thing to do, and just did it. You know, it wasn't for the sake of controversy. It was just part of my personality. A little bit bananas, and that's how I got into it. I'm glad I did it. It was my little touch with history, and I appreciate my role in that very, very much, and glad I had a role in it. Some people just sort of thrust into history, you know, and in a very small way, I was too. Life is full of choices, and we all have our things to live down. We all have our things we've got to make choices about. So I always appreciated that. That she never held it.